Ladies and gentlemen, Tactical Advance here, and welcome to a Star Citizen video today. We're going to have a bit of a conversation around selling and buying ships. Now, this is something I haven't covered before. I've been absorbing the information over the last sort of year, when the black market was there and the grey market and so on. And not just that side as well, but also individuals, let's say, melting down ships. Now, for the guys that don't know, there's a couple of options you can actually do. If you go and purchase a ship today, let's say if you buy a 325A and you got it with LTI. LTI gives you the lifetime insurance. Now, all other packages that you buy other than LTI normally come between 3 and 6 months on insurance anyway. LTI is not going to be totally groundbreaking. Where LTI comes in, guys, is if you own a ship with LTI and you sell it on the grey market, and what I mean by that is you don't sell it on the RSI site, you sell it to another individual. If you do that, then the LTI has value. For that reason, it does. And that's, I see that. The sort of topic I wanted to cover off today, really, is purchasing ships and finding the ships you want. Let's say, for instance, I buy a 325, and I've done the same thing, guys. I've done exactly the same thing. I've gone down this route myself to make this conclusion, what I've come to. I had the 325, and I sort of thought, I didn't really want to do fighting. I'm a sort of a PvE person, really. I'm not really a PvP person. So, you know, I'm going to buy ships that are more rowing orientated around PvE. So, exploration, maybe, haulage. There's a few others as well. Because that's sort of what I originally felt that I wanted to do in the game. Now, one of the tricky things you have is, let's say I still have my 325 now, A, right? What I don't know is I don't know what that ship's going to be in 6 months' time. I don't know what that ship's going to be in 18 months' time. And what I mean by that is when you originally buy the ship, and I've seen it happen so many times, you buy a ship, sits in the hangar, everyone stops talking about it, RSI, we get a patch, it maybe comes into the game, then there's a lot of another interest and another wave of people go and buy it. By this time, I'm thinking I might melt it down. So I go and melt it down. And what I mean by melting down, I go to the RSI site and let's say I refund it for in-game currency so I can buy another ship later on. I want the 325A back, right? Because what now you're getting further on down the line into the game, and I've purchased, let's say, for instance, a couple of other ships. I'm looking at that ship, and now I've played Arena Commander. I actually quite enjoy the PvP aspect, because the PvP is good. There is PvE. There's PvE dogfighting, something that originally I didn't really think of that I would have actually enjoyed doing, but I do. It's very difficult to make a decision. It's very difficult to look at the ships you've got and say, look, this is not for me, because it's very difficult to say, actually, do you know what, in 6-7 months' time, you might be looking back at that ship, regretting that you actually sold it. And I'm sure there's many people who have done the same thing. Melted down a ship, 4 or 5 months down the line, thought, oh, wish I kept that. And I'm following the same trait here. If you've got a ship in your hangar now, whether it's got LTI or not, have a look, a bit of a research into it. Go onto the RSI site, have a look what updates are coming. Think about what you actually want to do in the game. Try out Arena Commander. Try out the sort of multiplayer. Try out the Vandal Swarm. You know, try out Free Flight. See what you think of the ship. But you've got to keep an open mind. What you're flying today is not going to what you'll be flying in 6 to 18 months' time, because that ship is going through a process of not just improvements, but imbalancements, changes, weapon loadouts. You know, we're going to have new missiles soon. All the weapons are probably going to, well, they are going to be redesigned. We know we've got a massive wave of things coming. Some wise words is just have a think about it carefully before you actually go and melting something down. Because I definitely got a regret. I wish I kept my 325A. There's nothing I can do now. All I can do is hope for another sale. Hold on to the ships you got. Unless, the only reason that I would suggest going down the road of melting all, you know, your ships down to get another ship. Firstly, you've got to be sure you want that ship. Secondly, you would do it for financial reasons. If you financially cannot get that next ship, and the only way you can get it is by melting down two of your ships, you need to have a really good think about it. because you're never going to get them back. And if they don't come on sale again, or they're not on LTI again, all of a sudden, you know, you've just lost them ships. And everyone seems to be going through that same process of actually having regrets that ships they've sold in the past. That's it for today, guys. Just some key pointers to when you're sort of buying and selling ships. It's not just about, yeah, I want this ship, I want that one. You've got to understand that the ship you're selling actually might turn out to be one of the better ships in that role in the game, within that ship size, within that role. Keep an open mind. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching today, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye now.